I am Professor Akro Gobo, a professor of applied meteorology and environmental management at the Rivers State University, Port Harcourt, Nigeria. Yeah, I recall there was just sometime a study we carried out on gas impact of gas flaring in Brutas to Umuchem communities in Rivers State. And we really discovered that the effect of gas flaring has been enormous. We did a comparative study, that is, at the Gruta and Umuchem communities, and also took a control site. You know what we mean by control sites? Where there are no much gas flaring activities, though the impact could, but it will not be as when it is compared to that particular site. And we discovered that the rate of some common ailments were much in this Gruta and UHM communities. Yes, the question will be, why is it related to gas flaring? But we noticed that when we did the health impact assessment, most of them were related to this inhaling of incomplete combustible gases in the Earth's atmosphere. So you notice that most times the children are having excessive coughing, asthma, breathing difficulties, and skin diseases that are related to these gas flaring activities. And since the country is dependent on oil and gas activities, they are after the money that will come from these activities than the health impact or what the people are passing through there. In fact, the gas flaring activities this time is compounded more with the issue of this introduction of this black soot in the Earth's atmosphere. I'm sure if you've been in the Niger Delta recent times, and Rivers State in particular, the issue of black soot is on alarming rates. What happens is that gas flaring, what does gas flaring do? It introduces high temperature into the Earth's atmosphere. And now again, you're coming to illegal refining activities, destroy the illegal refining by again setting them ablaze, setting them on fire. And when you do these things, you're also introducing heat into the Earth's atmosphere. You're also increasing the temperature in the Earth's atmosphere. And what is the effect of this is that the protective ozone layer, which protects the Earth's atmosphere, which protects us here and to take it lightly on the Earth's atmosphere, is destroyed. And so now we're having excessive heat because we have direct heat of the sun. The ozone layer is a kind of a protective layer, you know, that protects us from the direct rays of the sun. But this layer is completely almost destroyed in this area. So you notice that the ailments will be more, and I'm sure we will start making some more studies to know. But with this destruction of ozone layer, we know that these ailments will be more, especially for children, because children will start having breathing difficulties. The issue of heat in the night, you cannot sleep in the night, and you cannot open your windows because the whole place is choked up, and we are not breathing clean air anymore in this environment.